Hello everyone, here's a question. Evaluate the integral of x times natural log of 1 plus x to the fourth. This is a question from college calculus competition. How to solve this question? First, we can use integration by parts. Here is a formula. Just integral of u dv, then equal u times v, then minus v du. So we need to choose what is a u, what is a dv. So let's rewrite the integrand. So we're going to put the x after natural log. So then we have here. So we just put natural log first. 1 plus x to the fourth. Then write the x. Then x dx. Then we're going to choose natural log as u. So here, this is u, u just equal natural log, 1 plus x to the fourth. The reason is, when it differentiated, it simplifies. Then for this part, then we're going to set it as a dv. So dv equal x dx. The reason is it's easy to integrate. So in order to use a formula, we need to figure out what is a du. So then for du, just for natural log, take a derivative. So that is 1 over 1 plus x to the fourth. Then based on the chain rule, for the inside part, we need to take a derivative again. So that will be 4x to the third. Then from the dv, we're going to figure out what is the v. So v just for x dx, we take an integral. So that will be x squared over 2. So now we're going to use the formula. So then here we have, plug into the formula here, will be u times v. So that will be natural log 1 plus x to the fourth, then times x squared divided by 2, then minus the integral of v du. So then v here, x squared over 2, then times, so here we should have dx. Then here just 4x to the third over 1 plus x to the fourth, then dx. Then in the next line, we simplify. So we're going to write x squared over 2 first. It looks better. Okay, so then x squared over 2, then natural log 1 plus x to the fourth, then minus. So here, 2 and 4, they simplify just 2. Then we move the constant 2 to the front. So then here we have a 2, then x squared and the x to the third combined together. That's x to the fifth. Then just copy the denominator. X to the fourth, then dx. Because for the rest of the part, we're just working on this integral. So we have to use I1 for this part. Then in the final answer, we'll put this one back. Okay, so here we just use I1 for the first part. So then we need to work on this integral. So we cannot evaluate it right away. So we still need to do some work. Okay, so let's see here. So we copy x to the fifth on the top. We want to simplify this integral to something we can integrate. So we are going to do some algebra. So we're going to add plus x, then minus x. Then we put the dx. The reason we plus x minus dx, so plus minus cancel out, is still x to the fifth. The reason we're adding plus x, because we want to group the first two together. we want to separate this integral into two. So now let's see. So here we have I1, then we separate them into two integrals. So then the first one will be here. So x to the fifth plus x then over is the fourth. Then 1 plus x to the fourth, then dx. Then here, so negative 2 distribute to the second integral. So then negative, negative, positive. So we have 2, the integral x divided by x to the fourth, then dx. Okay, so here we continue here. Then you look inside. They have a common factor x. So that's why here we are going to take x outside. So here we have x to the fourth plus 1 here. Then on the bottom, we just copy the denominator. So then here just x to the fourth plus 1, then dx. Then for the second integral, we are going to put the 2 inside. So then we have 2x. Then here on the bottom, x to the fourth, we are going to write x squared squared. Then dx. So I will explain why we are doing this here in the next line. Then copy I1. Then here. So you can tell, so x to the fourth plus 1 on top and the bottom, it cancels out. So then here we have really simple integral. That just here only have x left. So then here we have dx. Then plus the second integral. So then see here, we want to reduce the power. So we put the x to the fourth to x squared and squared. Because we want to do a substitution. Because you see, if we set a new variable t equal x squared, so then the derivative of x squared is 2x. You see, we have a 2x here. So now let's see. So the derivative of t, so then just x squared, take a derivative, that's 2x dx. So then you see on the top, so on the top, you see we have 2x dx. So we have a 2x dx. So that's just t. So that's why this one on top, that's just dt. Then on the bottom, that's 1 plus x squared is a t, t squared. That's why on the bottom, that's a 1 plus t squared. Okay, so then the next step. So this is really simple integral, then just 2 times x squared divided by 2. So then for this one, just equal arctangent. Then the variable is a t. Then don't forget to put the plus c, the constant c at the end, because this one is an indefinite integral. Okay, so then for the final answer. So we'll put back what's the I1. So I1 is x squared over 2 natural log 1 plus x to the fourth. Then this one simplifies, that's x squared. So then here is an arctangent. What is a t? T is x squared. So that's why here is x squared. Then plus a constant c. So that is the answer for this question. Thanks for watching. See you next time.